All right. Well, I want to say hello to you. This is Matt Wright.
I'm Jeremy Elliott.
And today is Friday, July 2nd, 2010. And this is the first video of today. You know, we've got yesterday's videos up already. And take a look at them if you haven't already. Look through all of these. Every day we'll be putting them up. We're going to try to do weekends when we can, too. Yeah, you know, we're going to be trying to do 7 days a week.
Almost like a daily diary kind of thing, almost.
Exactly. For spiritual teaching and advice. Like, if you all have questions, write me, Jeremy, a message here at Facebook or on the YouTube page or whatever way you see best. You know, probably best at Facebook. Write us a message and we'll try to answer them quickly on here. Or if you just had something you'd rather not have discussed on here, you know, write us a message too on there or call, and then we can deal with it privately. But
remember, we're doing the best we can to answer everybody's calls and emails and requests from the get-go. Like I said, we're kind of going forward and backwards, trying to catch up with people, but we're doing the best we can, so just hang tight and have faith, you know.
Yeah.
Believe in us, we'll do the best we can.
Yeah, we try hard, you know. I mean, we're here to help you all. We got nothing but compassion and love for you all, and you know, for everybody. You know, that's something important. You know, I'm gonna write that down for later. We're gonna start with that, you know, because I left a blank space up here. This is our to-do list for some stuff, videos today, and ideas we had just coming up in the last few minutes.
Yeah.
At the top, somebody told me to write in my mind. Someone said, like, write, remember to be compassionate. You know, I wrote be first, and I forgot to write compassionate. And this now, I was like, well, what should we talk about? Something about compassion popped in my mind. I turned my head. It said be compassionate. And I was like, filled in compassionate.
One thing I've learned about compassion lately is that you have to learn to have compassion for uncompassionate situations.
Yeah. It's hard. It's not.
That's one thing, like, I'm learning. It's not easy for anyone, I don't think, you know, but to recognize it is a start, you know what I mean? I was explaining this to one of my friends yesterday that, you know, some of these things do come with age or time or learning or accepting or expanding, you know. It just, it comes with whatever, you know what I mean? But you have to start from the root. Or let's say the mustard seed.
Yeah, that's one way to put it. Or the seed. Yeah, the seed of anything is the beginning.
Yeah, the seed to compassion and accepting all things, good or bad, you know.
Yeah, but the quickest way you can start being compassionate is you can do it driving down the street. Practice it. Like, let's say, like, you practice it in traffic. Like, you know, the people around you. Try to sense what people are feeling. Look at the people in front of you. Just look at them without trying to think too much. But see if any images pop up in your mind's eye. See if any feelings go through you. See what you feel. And then see that way, when you sense their feelings, see if you can find empathy with them.
Yeah,
practice that, and then you can move into compassion.
One way I think that, you know, another way to do that is for compassion. Or, you know, for yourself and others and on compassionate situations too.
Yeah.
Is to be able to, you know, you recognize something negative in yourself, be able to say it, you know.
That's right. Compassion to yourself. Yes.
Yeah. Even if it's negative or positive, you should be able to say both about yourself. Like, we all have flaws, you know, we try to hide them all the time, but sometimes it's better just to put, maybe daily, say something that's not perfect about you to get, you know, and just get into the mindset that, you know, to let people know that you're trying to have compassion for them and you, you know. It's kind of hard to explain, but, you know, it's putting a kick into getting into compassion.
Yeah, I've gotten into compassion mode, and let me tell you, once you get doing it, it becomes automatic, and then you want to do it because you feel so happy inside. It can take you into an almost like a euphoric, ecstatic, spiritual state.
Yeah.
That's continuous. It just goes on and on. And you might never come down from. Just that alone can bring you into that euphoria.
Yeah.
you know, a natural high, basically. Like, that I can't compare to anything, any kind of drug or anything.
Try not to kill bugs, you know.
Right? That's one thing. That's something I practice. Yeah. I don't kill bugs.
Yeah, try. I mean, like, I've said before, like, sometimes I'll be trying to catch them, and I'll end up hurting them or killing them on accident, and, you know, and I say, that was their day, I guess. But
yeah,
it's not like, you know, if you practice trying to take the bug outside, like, get off your butt, kind of, to take the bug outside.
Yeah.
That's doing compassion. You know, or walking down the street and you see litter and you pick it up and you put it in the trash can. It seems such like a very small idea.
I practice that too.
Yeah, but it'll go far for you. Karma
goes a long way.
Both of those things.
Because you're taking care of the earth that way.
Exactly.
And both ways. And there's a lot of ways you can do it. And I do it like with people around me, people walking down the street. Just smiling, like keep a smile on your face. And the smile itself will have an effect on you physically and spiritually. Mm-hmm. I've noticed that smiling itself can affect you, the feel that.
I mean, you made a good point the other day about, you know, knowing that, like, even when you're by yourself, smiling is good therapy. You know, smiling by yourself, even in
it helps.
Even when you're on your own, you know, not people aren't looking at you. Smile.
Smile anyway.
Yeah, keep you going, you know, get you happier feeling. It's a true thing, because I practiced it after Matt said it. Made more positive change in my mood. Yeah.
Let me talk about another thing that will develop too. Once you start beginning to feel some real compassion, and you're practicing it, you'll start to be more empathic. Like sometimes you'll be able to physically feel other people, like what they're going through.
Yeah.
Like my friend Tony was sick one time about even a month ago. Well, it's been a couple months now, but almost 2 months. But yeah, he had to go to the hospital. He was so sick, puking, and that because his vision was blurred and all this stuff came on suddenly. But then I could feel it all. I was practicing compassion real hard that past week and that day.
Yeah.
And then I felt the headache. I could feel the nausea coming on in me, but I wasn't sick with it. I just was feeling him. From, you know, feeling his vibes. I could feel this frustration at waiting in the hospital and all the other stuff I felt. But, like, I was sitting there practicing compassion all day. You know, for the nurses, like the nurses, I could tell they were frustrated at public coming in. I was practicing compassion for the doctors and nurses going by, you know, sending love, trying to be understanding. Compassion is understanding in action. That just came to instant.
Yeah.
I saw the words in my mind. Popped in instantly.
I saw the words love and compassion divided by all things.
Yeah.
Because you can say your favorite. You say, what do I love the most? And even if it's the worst thing, what if it's drugs? Or what if you say I love sex? Or, you know, it's something to say that's the worst thing. I'm just saying, but what if you say you love people or whatever? But whatever you love... Divided by everything.
Yeah, I wrote compassion is understanding, and I wrote love, and then all things.
Yeah.
And I have a little dividing mark.
Yeah, you divide it by all things. How much you love your most loved thing, then divide it by all things. And then you'll kind of start to see what you mean by compassion, you know what I mean, and love.
I can see that compassion, like the way the subject came up, is almost... It's a psychic in itself. I don't know if I...